The members present, I declare the motion passed. Electoral Legislation Miscellaneous Amendments Bill 2014. We now resume the second reading debate on the Shipping Legislation Control of Smoke Emission Amendment Bill 2014. Mr. Kenneth Chen will now address the Council on the Committee's report. Mr. Kenneth Chen. Yes, President, thank you. As Chairman of the Bills Committee on the Shipping Legislation Control of Smoke Emission Amendment Bill 2014, I would like to report to members the deliberations of the Bills Committee. The bill seeks to amend Cap 313 and Cap 548, and they are the Shipping and Port Control Ordinance and the Merchant Shipping Ordinance. And So concerning the intensity of emission, if it is found to be as dark as or darker than shade 2 on the Ringelmann chart and that such emission has lasted for 3 minutes or more, that would be regarded as an offence. And the bill also raises the maximum penalties for non-local vessels concerning first offence as well as repeated offences. The Bills Committee has held a total of 2 meetings. At one of its meetings, the Bills Committee met deputations. During the scrutiny of the bill, some members asked whether the Ringelmann chart should be used as the benchmark or the reference for taking enforcement action against emission from vessels. That was because members realized that only a few ports were using the Ringelmann chart as the reference. Now, according to the administration, the statement by the responsible MD officers or witnesses would be the most important evidence, and other documents or photographs would only serve as supporting information in prosecution. Concerning publicity and education, the Marine Department will be distributing copies of the Ringelmann chart to the public and to port users, and the administration will also be explaining the Ringelmann chart to those concerned. And if the emission problem deteriorates, then the administration will consider taking stronger action. Members note that some deputations oppose the proposed amendments to Cap 313 concerning requiring the agents of local vessels to show their responsibility for excessive smoke emission. So in other words, the owner and the agent both have to show the responsibility. But administration has explained that the agent has been commissioned by the owner to carry out the maintenance works and the repair works. And so agents should show the same responsibilities as the owners. And some members are concerned that non-local vessels heavier penalties apply to non-local vessels. According to the administration, the power ratings of engines of non-local vessels or ocean-going vessels are higher than those of local vessels. And so if the engines are not maintained properly, then the emission of dark smoke will be more serious. And that's why there are heavier penalties for ocean-going vessels. But then for local vessels, the maximum fines are at reasonable levels and can also achieve a deterrent effect. And then some have proposed an imprisonment term for repeated offences, but according to the administration, between 2007 to 2013, the cases of excessive dark smoke emission dropped, and so there was no need to introduce an imprisonment term as the penalty. And so the Bills Committee has raised no objection to adopting the Ringelmann chart as the reference for taking enforcement and prosecution action. I want to now talk about the position of the Civic Party. We support the proposals in the bill, President. The This is because the amendments apply to Shipping and Port Control Ordinance and the Merchant Shipping Local Vessels Ordinance, and objective standards are introduced into the two ordinances. And the so-called more objective standards, in fact, refer to the Ringelmann chart. And as a result, we have a more objective benchmark or reference for measuring the intensity of emission. And also, the highest penalties for ocean-going vessels are higher than those for local vessels. The Civic Party is of the view that these arrangements will be effective and will also help enforcement officers, as they will have an objective reference to go by. In fact, during the scrutiny of the bill, some details were discussed, and I would like to express my party's concerns to the administration. In fact, as I stated in my report, heavier penalties have been proposed for ocean-going vessels, but not for local vessels. Now, the administration has given an explanation for such an approach, but then I think it's important that we remind all port users, all ship owners and their agents, and also masters, coxswains, that they should pay attention to the problem of emission of dark smoke. And we should increase their environmental awareness. And so in future, if the problem deteriorates, then the administration should carry out a review as soon as possible to see whether the penalties need to be adjusted upwards or increased. I understand that there is some controversy surrounding the introduction of the Ringelmann chart as the reference for enforcement and prosecution action. There are some ports around the world which use the Ringelmann chart, but there are only a few such ports, and there are ports which still rely on visual inspection, and there are some ports which measure the pollutants in the ports. The Civic Party supports the introduction of the Ringelmann chart into our legislation, but we are of the view that the administration isn't really fully prepared yet, and it has not really convinced members that the Ringelmann chart is the most objective and reliable reference for taking enforcement and prosecution action. And also, during this course of the scrutiny of the bill, some members asked whether the Ringelmann chart could be widely distributed to members of the public. For example, the chart be distributed in the North Point, in Tong Chong, or in Tsim Sha Tsui, or on both sides of the Victoria Harbour? Can the public be voluntary spotters to help identify smoky vessels and refer the cases to the government for further action? But the administration once said that there might be a copyright problem. And as a result, it didn't feel that it was appropriate to widely distribute the Ringelmann chart to members of the public. But then it was discovered that, in fact, there was no copyright problem at all. So I think our officials should do more research and should not try to invent answers without having done proper research. Now, I'm not saying that there is a credibility problem on the part of our officials, but then I think we should guard against such habits. In other words, when we scrutinize a bill, we should take care of quality, quantity, speed, as well as efficiency. In fact, as the chairman of the Bills Committee, I have heard a lot of views from organizations and from members of the public at large. Now, under this bill, the Ringelmann chart is formally adopted as a reference. Now, we know that concerning nuisance caused by emission, we now have the objective benchmarks. For example, shade two or darker than shade two on the Ringelmann chart, and that the emission has lasted for 3 minutes or more. So, in the Hong Kong waters, for ocean-going vessels as well as local vessels, now very often with if people see the dark smoke emitted, they will take photos or they will take videos, and then such will be handed to the Marine Department. This is because the emissions will be detrimental to public health. And some people ask or have asked why, whether if the legislation is passed, then complaints. Such complaints will no longer be entertained. In other words, at the moment people take photos or take videos and then pass them on to the Marine Department. The Marine Department has said that it will continue to accept such information. And I hope that for members of the public, even if you don't have the Ringelmann chart with you, you should still take photographs, you should still take videos, and after the Marine Department will still study the information passed to you. In fact, designing Hong Kong, in fact, only a few days ago, wrote to me as the chairman of the Bills Committee, and in fact, that letter has been copied to the Marine Department. And they hope that the reference should be this reference should be retained, and that is the level of smoke emission, which is of such an intensity as to cause nuisance. So they are not saying that the Ringelmann chart should not be adopted, but they hope that this description should also be adopted. In other words, both references should coexist. But of course, I understand that as we've come to this stage, we can't reinstate a certain part of the bill which has been deleted. So I, in fact, have tried to explain the situation to Designing Hong Kong, and the organization is willing to accept the explanation. But then, as the chairman of the Bills Committee, I want to say this again to the Marine Department and to the Bureau. There are the members of the public do not have the Ringelmann chart with them, and so when district councillors complain or when they see emissions from vessels near South Horizons in North Point or in Tung Chung, they may still rely on the traditional ways of making complaints. So I hope that the secretary can step up publicity. And I hope that you understand that during this transitional period, members of the public may not know what the Ringelmann chart is about. And so, if members of the public want to help you by providing you with photographs of smoky vessels, please continue to accept or deal with such complaints. And President, concerning penalties, I want to say that the administration has given us some information about the dates of prosecution, the types of vessels involved, and the number of persons prosecuted and convicted, and the fines. You may think that the fine can achieve a deterrent effect as level four, but in actual fact, There was one case on the 26th of October 2007, and the case occurred in the western waters of the Victoria Harbour. That was a river vessel. And in fact, that was shade 4 on the Ringelmann chart, and the emission lasted for 4 minutes, and only $700 fine was handed down. So was the fine high enough to achieve a deterrent effect? So we need to also consider whether the Marine Department has been too lenient in its enforcement action. I think we should look at the past cases, the more serious cases in particular. In other words, when there was a high intensity of emission, according to the Ringelmann chart, for example, shade 4, and yet the fine was so small. So in future, the Marine Department needs to step up enforcement action, and the Marine Department will in future be armed with a more objective reference. So can the deterrent effect or the desired deterrent effect be achieved? And the Civic Party president hopes that the air quality in Hong Kong can be improved as soon as possible. In fact, with regard to the third runway proposal, of course, it has a lot to do with our air quality and the problem of air pollution. So why is it that when we discuss the third runway proposal, only Dr. Anthony Cheung is present and not the Secretary for the Environment? Now, I understand that today, as the department responsible for taking action is the Marine Department, we have the STH here to answer our questions and to respond to our comments. But then I hope that the administration can make sure that there is interdepartmental cooperation and coordination to try to tackle the air pollution problem in Hong Kong. I think the most important thing to do is to protect the health of the Hong Kong public. And we hope that enforcement action can be stepped up, there can be more deterrent penalties so that air quality can be enhanced. Thank you.
Ms. Ho, air pollution in Hong Kong can be partly attributed to the emissions of vessels in the harbour. That's a significant contributing factor, although we are in favor of controlling emission. But there was something quite funny when we scrutinized the bill. In the past, the method adopted was visual inspection. So if you saw something wrong, you make you lodge a complaint, and the Marine Department also do something to visual inspection will be carried out, and then prosecution may follow. But then the number of prosecution cases dropped. Although visual inspection is not objective, but the use of a Ringelmann chart is also not very objective. In the last page of the document is the chart for shapes 1, 2, 3, 4. If it's a shape 2 or darker than shape 2 for more than 3 minutes, it's an offense. If you observe the emission from a chimney, well, it's not there, it's not stilled. There may be a wind that would blow it away or dilute it. And the wind speed is not constant. Sometimes it's stronger, sometimes it's weaker. So it's difficult to count the time that to make sure that it's over 3 minutes. This Ringelmann chart has a history of more than 120 years. I believe when Japan saw the first foreign ships in the Meiji era, it was already there. The chart was already there. Some more than 100 years have passed, and still we are using this traditional and tested way for law enforcement officers to carry out visual inspection. This is a dark humor. I used to work in the textile industry. I was very sensitive to colors. In my previous occupation, I learned a scientific trick. And that is, we have pigments in our eyes. The pigment decides the color of our eyes, and also it determines how we perceive colors. And the pigments in a person is different from that in another person. So color blue and color purple may mean different things to different people. Some people may think that a purple car and a blue car are the same, but to another person, they are different in color. In an election forum, I saw Mrs. Regina Yim wearing a gray jacket on the television, but actually it was light purple. So that could also happen to machines. So the color can mean different things to different people. And now we are saying that this is a major improvement. We are more objective. We have the Ringelmann chart. But this is really the ridiculous. We have many methods. There are many methods to control emission. For example, the Environment Bureau has recently reduced the cap on sulfur content in diesel from 0.5% to 0.05%. But the diesel to be used is only about marine traffic within Hong Kong waters. So the diesel use should have the sulfur content reduced to 0.05% across the board. But I believe the administration is not in favor of such a rash move because of business sector objection. We also ask for the switch of a fuel after the vessel has berthed in Hong Kong waters. I hope this can be implemented soon. What is even more helpful is to provide onshore power supply. At the Kai Tak cruise terminal, we want to develop cruise tourism. From very often we have big ocean-going vessels berthed there. And when they are berthed, they need to provide power to the vessel, which is just a small housing estate equivalent. That's why we want to see onshore power supply facilities installed at the Kai Tak cruise terminal. But the administration told us that there are different standards for different countries, and we'll have to wait until there's a standard agreed upon by various countries. But of us, people in the industry, on the size of a power plant to provide power to meeting different standards. It was just the size of a classroom. So what it takes will be to build an additional power plant the size of a classroom to meet two different sets of standards of cruises. If we can do that, the emission from cruises will not be affecting Kowloon City residents. And these people would not have to suffer poorer air quality because we want to promote cruise tourism. And now we have this very subjective enforcement method of visual inspection based on the recommend chart. I hope the administration would employ other measures. The administration should provide onshore power supply and also to reduce the sulfur content of all vessels, diesels, to 0.05% and not just for those within the harbor.
Mr. Ho Chun-yin, I want to speak on behalf of the DAB on this bill. In fact, Mr. Chen, the chairman of the Bills Committee, and Ms. Ho have already given a lot of comments on this bill. I think there was consensus reached in the Bills Committee. In fact, the bill is very simple. It proposes to increase the penalties. Second, it proposes to adopt the Ringelmann chart as the reference. In fact, the Ringelmann chart has all along been referred to by the courts. But now the administration is proposing that the Ringelmann chart be formally adopted as the reference for taking enforcement and prosecution action. The Marine Department complained about enforcement difficulties. Now, Mr. Kenneth Chen mentioned the case in which the fine was only $700. Now, I understand that for non-local vessels, for the first offense, the fine is $10,000. So why was it that in that case, the fine was only $700? We don't know. And now we're talking about $10,000 for the first offense and then $25,000 fine for repeated offenses. I think we shouldn't be discussing why the court has decided to hand down a certain level of fine. And then second, yes, we all want to protect our environment. But if we continue to tighten our legislation, will difficulties or hardship be caused to certain sectors in the community? Now, as Mr. Tao has pointed out, the bill on low sulfur content of diesel has been passed. So those standards have been tightened. But then how can we increase the efficiency of our fishing vessels? Now, for example, concerning the power ratings of the engines, say if it's 100 at the moment, I really can't increase it to 150. And yet, the fuel that we are allowed to use is less efficient, and as a result, the overall efficiency will be will drop. So, what can be done to help the fishing vessel owners? I hope that the administration can offer some solutions for them. And in fact, some in the Bills Committee have asked why the administration has chosen to adopt the Ringelmann chart. I think I can say that to a certain extent, the controversy affected the relationship between the executive and the legislature. May I refer to paragraph 5 of the paper dated the 30th of May? It is said concerning overseas port authorities which have adopted the Ringelmann chart. According to the administration, this is the only known device or tool that has been adopted by ports in other parts of the world. So so members were led to believe that the Ringman chart was excellent, it was widely used, and as a result, we should promote the use of the Ringman chart. But then concerning para, may I refer to para 2, we have two ports in the Middle East, some ports in this in South Africa, and some in Europe, and we have UK, Hamburg, Rotterdam, Melbourne, and Singapore. These ports have responded to our inquiries, and only one of these ports has adopted the Ringman chart as the reference. So at the time, we asked the administration whether the Ringman chart was the only solution to the problem, whether the Ringman chart was the only way to achieve the objective behind the legislation. So I hope that in future, we can be given better papers. We hope that more forceful and convincing arguments can be put forward by the administration to convince us to come round to their points of view. But in the Bills Committee, all the members did their homework, and they agreed that adopting the Ringman chart would be better than having no objective reference at all. And so I want to say that I, Stephen Ho, with some reluctance, I have decided to support your bill.
Mr. Lam Kwok Hong, well, I find it strange that a party member has just said that he does not represent his party. I have been taking the administration to task for not being competent. Now, Mr. Stephen Ho, if you think they have not done a good job, why don't you seek to amend it and ask them to adopt a new way of doing it? This is really an executive legislature problem. The administration is almost saying take it or leave it because I have enough votes, or if you criticize them enough, they will bring in some improvements. I find this very strange. The administration spend a lot of time on anti-smoking. Actually, as I said in the budget debate, there is a big problem of marine emission. It affects the atmosphere as well as our respiration. As far as I know, you need to reduce waste at source. You allowed people to use fuel with a high sulfur content. And now you are saying we will do something because you have scolded us for so long. However, you don't do a perfect job. I remember the nonsense of the administration was that if we should control the vessels, then foreign vessels would not come to Hong Kong. But now you have refuted your own argument. My view is, as long as a cat catches mice, it doesn't matter whether it is a black cat or a white cat. Now, I don't know too much about Ringelmann charts. I'd like to know, why don't you take a multi-pronged approach so that you can apply various regulations. Say if you apply three criteria to test the vessels, then it's easy to catch them as long as they break two or three of the rules. So I'd like to ask my colleagues, what is the good of the Ringelmann chart? As Ms. Sitho said, people have different interpretations of the chart. Why don't you do something about marine fuel? Ah, oh, Mr. Stephen Ho, it's not even in the chamber. Now, if you do something about marine fuel, then why is it that the DAB is not speaking on behalf of the so-called victims? I find this strange. That is the position of the DAB. This is a vivid example showing that the administration will only react to repeated criticism. And also, they would seek to pass bills and other things here if we do not if we act in a passive manner. So at any time at all, during the budget or otherwise, when we filibuster and when we question the administration so that it is anxious and embarrassed, now you know why we do it. Because the administration has a lot of power, it has vast resources. The council represents the public and different strata and interest groups to monitor and press the government to work. And of course, if it is an election year, you know, every 4 years we have elections, and the election results are also a product of power struggle. Mr. President, I think you are really smart in answering the remark made by C.Y. Leung. This is just a small bill. Those parties that support the administration criticize the administration, and those who do not support the administration, of course, find this an imperfect job. Now we have such a big backlog, and yet you still submit this bill, and we would just have to rush through with it. Okay, I'll stop here, Mr. President, but allow me to make just one more point. At the council here, if you don't act in your position to monitor the administration, then you are letting down your constituents. Those who monitor the administration may not always be in the right. Those members may be refuted by the administration and other colleagues. Now, just like what I'm doing today, because I don't exactly know this bill, and you will say, what is this guy talking about? He doesn't even know the bill. But the lesson of the story is, if you really want to improve the executive-legislature relationship, then first of all, you have to discharge your duties as legislators. I find it more strange that sometimes colleagues criticize the administration and yet you still vote for them. And the administration will get into the habit of pressing you, coaxing you into doing something and say that you stand in the way and you better not say so much. That is nonsense, of course, right? Mr. Leung, you have deviated from the topic. Sorry, you have digressed. Okay, let me come back to the Ringelmann chart. According to Ms. Sit Ho, it might have been used during the Meiji Restoration. It was in the 1840s. Ah, no, you must be wrong. It must not have been here for 200 years. It was only a century old. But, President, let me ask you this. Would you apply something that is a century old and say that is the only tool you have? This is not what I said, because I have not studied into the issue. I heard what Mr. Stephen Ho said, and he has exposed the entire problem. What can members say if the administration says it is only happy with the Ringelmann chart, and if you insist on other things, I will not propose the bill? President, I'm not digressing at all. If the council can write its own bill, if we are allowed to move private bills or private members' bills, then Mr. Stephen Ho and Ms. Sit Ho together, the two Ho's, can propose a bill. In this process of political compromise or struggle, if the administration doesn't listen to us, then we can come up with a private member's bill and I don't have to talk to you. So, the rules of the council have changed now. If we have more power to move bills, then we can resort to a private member's bill, right, Kenneth Chan? You don't have to say at length if that's the case. Now, okay, I won't say more, or else I will be said to be digressing. Where is Elizabeth Quart? This story tells us that you don't only try to see whether someone is wearing shorts. That doesn't do. You have to say things that are related to the public interest. Now you're really digressing. Okay, I will allow Mr. Albert Chan to speak. He is, of course, going to digress as well. Does any other member wish to speak, Mr. Albert Chan?
I want to make 3 points. The people's power to welcome this bill. When it comes to the enforcement, the standard to be applied, would adopt a wait-and-see attitude. I don't think any member here is professionally knowledgeable about the system. I've been handling the cases of odor and smoke from vessels for many years. In Chun-yin, there is an anchorage point for dangerous vessels carrying dangerous goods. Many years ago, at night, people could detect a bad odor. Some people call 999. I also did call 999. The Marine Department would spend the whole night. It was dark, and the department couldn't find which vessel was responsible for that. The Marine Department is weak in enforcing the laws on sea. First of all, there are many vessels. Second, there's very little the department can do. I did lodge complaints saying that the barge would come into our harbor, into the bay at 3 or 4 a.m. and still it would sound its horn. And everyone living in that area would hear the sound. The horn was sounded in order to remind other vessels that it was coming in. And there are other complaints related to various problems, illegal fishing, and so on and so forth. I would say that our waters is not really enforced by anyone. Of course, we welcome the legislative amendments, but I have grave doubts about the ability to enforce the law. I welcome the stepping up of marine enforcement. But air pollution is also unregulated. I've complained for many years about pollution caused by aircraft. The pollutants come in many forms and shapes, such as suspended particulates. And vessels can be found in various parts of the sea. But aircraft pollutants are restricted to particular areas. And and here we're talking about the chemicals, RSPs, NOx, and carbon dioxide. Chung-chung alone takes it all. So, Secretary, while you work hard to regulate pollution at sea, please also regulate pollution caused by aircraft. And I don't think it should be the job of the transport and housing bureau. It should be the job of the Environment Bureau. The Environment Bureau should be empowered to deal with all kinds of pollution. And I also want to make a further point, and the Secretary may not be aware of this. You take sample tests of vessel fuel from time to time. The vessels know when you are going to take a sample from them, and when it's time to take a test sample, they use the proper fuel, but not during other times. I don't know how you're going to enforce this new law at night. In the examples, there's quota in the anchorage point, when you have a problem, when the officers of the Marine Department have all gone to bed, they would clean their machines or the fuel tank. And when the Marine Department officer arrives at the scene, all the pollutants have gone. And there's no way you can take a video recording because it's at night. So enforcement is a problem. And I've said that the capability of the Marine Department is weak. And also it's the same with littering or dumping of waste. Maybe the vessels do not dare to do it within mainland waters. But if you look at the beaches from Mui Wo along the coast of Lantau, they are littered with all sorts of waste. So the department cannot regulate the use of illegal fuel or tax unpaid, duty unpaid fuel, and you cannot really regulate the dumping of waste. How can you assure us that you can really regulate air pollution? Does any other member wish to speak? Then the Secretary for Transport and Housing, it's time for you to reply.
President, first of all, I have to thank the Bills Committee. Under the leadership of Mr. Kenneth Chan, for the comprehensive scrutiny of the Shipping Legislation Control of Smoke Emission Amendment Bill 2014, the Bills Committee also held a hearing so that today we can resume second reading debate of the bill. I have heard many members speak in the second reading debate. Members addressed different points, especially enforcement and possible problems. I thank them for their valuable views, which will be followed up upon. The aim of the bill is to increase the capacity of the Marine Department in controlling dark smoke from vessels. We propose to use the Ringelmann chart as an objective benchmark for enforcement. It is stated in the law that any vessels in Hong Kong waters should not emit smoke darker than shade 2 on the Ringelmann chart and should not do so continuously for 3 minutes or above. This was also the case after the Director of Audit's report last year. The PAC considered that view, and it was actually the PAC's request that we should legislate for this as soon as possible. I'm very happy that the bill is unanimously supported by the Bills Committee, even though some members, of course, just now supplemented many views. Mr. Kenneth Chan mentioned that some deputations asked why we could not preserve the present basis for law enforcement, and that is nuisance in addition to the Ringelmann chart. Indeed, in the law now, we make use of the concept of nuisance. But then this is exactly because our law enforcement experience tells us that making use of the ground of nuisance does not afford us a very clear criterion. And also it has been difficult to adduce evidence, and that is why we propose not to make use of the nuisance concept but to adopt a more objective criterion, and that is the Ringelmann chart. Internationally speaking, at certain ports where a quantifiable standard is used, it would invariably use the Ringelmann chart. I'm talking about ports in the UK and also in California and New York in the US. Ms. Sitholm mentioned that actually this Ringelmann chart is very old. Yes, it has a long history, but it doesn't mean that it cannot be used. But I have to accept the view that after all, this is a chart and there are four shades in the chart to facilitate the measurement. Now we propose to make use of shade 2 in the Ringelmann chart. In the actual visual inspection, of course, we may be affected by the the situation. However, compared to the present ordinance, which makes use of nuisance as a concept, we believe the Ringelmann chart will be more effective. If, on the one hand, we preserve nuisance, which is not exactly defined and which is a subjective kind of judgment, and at the same time we add Ringelmann chart to the law, then maybe the industry may have difficulty complying with the law. So from the point of view of clarity for law enforcement, we believe the Ringelmann chart is more desirable. Also, at present, starting from 2005, in vetting and approving the renewal of certificate of survey by vessels once every year or 2 years, the Marine Department has already made use of the same standard in the Ringelmann chart, meaning Shade 2. In other words, the industry is not starting from zero. It knows about what Shade 2 of the Ringelmann chart means. And also, according to the Air Pollution Control of Smoke Ordinance, Cap 311C, with regard to the sections on chimney stacks installed on land or on vessels, again, it makes use of the Ringelmann chart as the only criterion. So the chart may not be perfect, but from the angle of law enforcement, and also because it is an internationally accepted standard, we believe it should be acceptable. If the bill is supported and read the third time today, the Marine Department will start publicity and education immediately to distribute the Ringelmann chart to the industry and also the public. But I must apologize that during the bill's committee's scrutiny, officials were worried about the copyright issue, but now this has been cleared up, and I thank Mr. Kenneth Chen for pointing this out, and our colleagues would be doubly prudent in addressing these issues later. We will also distribute publicity pamphlets to remind the industry that they must comply with the law and not allow vessels to emit smoke that is to a standard more than the concentration allowed. The Marine Department will also teach the public to identify law-breaking vessels so they can report to the MD. The MD has already liaised with the Southern District Office, and in August, there will be two talks in the Southern District for ship owners, coxswains, and ship operators, and also to the public so that we can brief them on the requirements of the law, and similar talks will then also be provided in other districts. Some members are worried about enforcement. In terms of enforcement, the MD has already completed training on the use of the Ringelmann chart, so Marine officials can make use of the Ringelmann chart in order to assess the dark smoke situation. As I said, in terms of a renewal of certificate of survey and also in the first issue of the survey certificate, the chart will already be used. The MD will take special actions every year in order to do visual inspection on different types and sizes of vessels in the harbor. And depending on the concentration and the time the smoke is emitted, there could be advice, warnings, or even prosecutions taken out against vessels. Starting from 2007, the visual inspections of the MD show that the number of vessels that emit dark smoke has dropped from 40.8% in 2007 to 1.4% in 2013, showing that the situation has very much improved. However, no matter what, we believe law enforcement should be stepped up, and also we need to increase the knowledge of the industry and also the public on their awareness. The MD will maintain the force of law enforcement, and if necessary, it will be stepped up, and also investigation will be conducted in reaction to complaints by the public. As members were saying, I'm sure the community is now very concerned about air quality in Hong Kong and in neighboring areas. So apart from the MD, I urge the public to also help monitor the situation and, if necessary, make reports or complaints to the MD. We distribute such Ringelmann chart cards, and that can also be used by the public. In terms of penalties, the bill proposes to increase by a wide margin fines for local vessels. The first offense will attract $25,000 instead of $10,000 fine, and a repeated offense that would be subject to a fine of $50,000 instead of $20,000. This is for non-local vessels. This is actually a big jump in the figures. We have explained to the Bills Committee why we need to introduce such big changes to non-local vessels. This is because usually these vessels are OGVs with bigger engines. And if there is poor maintenance of these engines in ocean-going vessels, there will be more emission of dark smoke than local vessels. As for local vessels, since the scale of their operation is small, we believe the maximum fine is already a deterrent, meaning $10,000 for the first offense or $25,000 for a repeated offense. Of course, we must remain alert. We will keep track of the actual situation, and if necessary, we will certainly make a review. And also, vessel owners, agents, and also the coxswains are all responsible to ensure that the vessels have suitable maintenance and operate well. Therefore, if any vessel should flout the dark smoke emission requirement, these people may all be subject to prosecution. In scrutinizing the bill, in response to the request of the Bills Committee, the MD asked 22 major ports about how they control dark smoke. We, of course, made inquiries with all 22 overseas ports, but not everybody responded. Now, basing on the response and also from information known to the MD, we know some ports do not introduce such assessment criterion, and other ports actually legislate for certain assessment criteria to be used. And all those that have such standards make use of the Ringelmann chart, as I said, as in the UK and some ports in the US. Whether we use visual inspection or the Ringelmann chart, none is perfect. But as I said, the Ringelmann chart would be very helpful for law enforcement. I'd now like to respond to what members said just now, and that is, we should not just concentrate on the Ringelmann chart. Rather, we should look wider to see how we can maintain or enhance our air quality. I fully support that view. In fact, we know that relying on the Ringelmann chart alone to target dark smoke emission by vessels is just a deterrent. It is not an ultimate solution. All in all, we must tackle the sources of pollution. Hong Kong is just like other international ports. We also want to do more in this respect. We like to ask vessels to make use of cleaner fuels. In April this year, the EPD has launched a new requirement saying that for marine light diesel supplied locally, the sulfur content should be reduced from 0.5% to 0.05%. And the EPD is prepared to make this a legislative requirement, meaning that when OGVs berth in Hong Kong, they must change to a fuel with a sulfur content not more than 0.5%. And the relevant law is being drafted, and if it will receive the support of this council, we hope it will become effective next year. Just now, Ms. It Ho mentioned onshore electricity, and she talked about the ocean terminal and the Kai Tak cruise terminal and also container ports. The EPD told us that for the Kai Tak cruise terminal to have onshore electricity, the administration has started a technical feasibility study in November last year, and it will be completed shortly. After that, we will avail ourselves to the results to make other plans. As for onshore electricity for ocean terminal and container ports, the EPD has said that it has taken up the matter with the operators to see how onshore electricity can be supplied. They will look at a feasibility. Hopefully, we can come back with the results soon. President, implementing the proposal in the bill will help the MD to do law enforcement more effectively to target dark smoke emission by vessels, thereby improving air quality in Hong Kong. I now move the resumption of second reading debate on the Shipping Legislation Control of Smoke Emission Amendment Bill 2014, and I urge for members' support.
I now put a question to, and that is that the Shipping Legislation Control of Smoke Emission Amendment Bill 2014 be read a second time. Will those in favour please raise their hands? Those against? I think the question is agreed by a majority of the members present. I declare the motion passed. Shipping Legislation Control of Smoke Emission Amendment Bill 2014. Committee stage. Council is now in committee. I now propose the question two, and that is that the following clauses stand part of the Shipping Legislation Control of Smoke Emission Amendment Bill 2014. Clauses 1 to 7. Does any member wish to speak? I now put the question to you as stated. Will those in favour please raise their hands? Those against? I think the question is agreed by a majority of the members present. I declare the motion passed. Council now resumes. Third reading, Shipping Legislation Control of Smoke Emission Amendment Bill 2014. Secretary for Transport and Housing. President, the Shipping Legislation Control of Smoke Emission Amendment Bill 2014 has passed through the committee stage without amendment. I move that the bill be read the third time and do pass. I now propose a question to you, and that is that the Shipping Legislation Control of Smoke Emission Amendment Bill 2014 be read the third time and do pass. I now put the question to you as stated. Will those in favour please raise their hands? Those against? I think the question is agreed by a majority of the members present. I declare the motion passed. Shipping Legislation Control of Smoke Emission Amendment Bill 2014. We'll now resume the second reading debate on the Stamp Duty Amendment Bill 2013. The Chairman of the Bills Committee.